So here we are. This is my setup. Here is an iPod second generation, 8 gig, still working. Here is the 300 watt power supply unit. Let's focus on that just to feed the amp, this car amp. Here is a positive yellow cord coming from this PC Molex. Here is a black ground, so it provides the negative for the amp. Here we have a power cord, standard power cord, using I am using the brown cable as a positive, and the yellow and the blue cable as the ground cable. Switching to here, I have the connection. As you can see, the blue goes on ground. Trying to focus. Okay, focused. Blue cable goes on ground. Brown cable goes on the power, the 12 volts positive side. Then I have a bridge with a speaker cable over here. I have a bridge so it can go to the remote joint, so it can trick the subwoofer to think that is that the car is on, so it can switch on. Here I have an RCA cable with the yellow budge on the left side and the red connection on the right side. Here are the volume control, and here I have the subwoofer set to bass, and then I will switch to full just to show you the sound and how it works. So let's power the power supply unit. I will try to zoom again. Okay, 300 max wattage. So it's just any regular PC power supply unit might do the trick. At least if it at least has the wattage, just like the subwoofer or the amp needs. So this is a 400 watt subwoofer with an amp already built in. So let's just power the iPod. I'm going to power this music video so you can watch how it works. So you can see this is a subwoofer powered by a power supply PC unit, so you can work in your house, in your home, or anywhere where you have a power supply. So this is the connections. Just you could use a Molex extension. Try to zoom. You could use a Molex female extension to do this trick. You just need to power the yellow to your positive side and the black one to the to the ground or to the negative side. So then I could just switch this on to this power supply without changing this, or you can even connect it to a power supply unit of a computer that is already turned on a computer, so you don't need to damage any power supply. You could use an extra extension, a female extension, just to clip it on over here on the Molex cable, and it will be powered on. So because I just used this power supply that I was going to throw to the garbage, and so now it is powering my amp. So this is just a regular 400 watt subwoofer with an amp built in. This is a Xlopd subwoofer, 400 watt subwoofer. It's just a rip-off of a Sony Xplode subwoofer, but it actually sounds pretty good, as you can see. So here is it set to bass, and I'm going to try to switch to full, and then I'm going to adjust the sound so you can hear. I will try to switch now. See, I have bass, then I'm going to switch to full. As you can see, it can sound pretty good. I'm going to then max the music volume so you can hear how loud it can reach. A little bit of distortion, because this is an iPod. We don't have any filters nor amps in between, just power, just a sound, regular RCA sound cord, just clip on the subwoofer. I'm going to try to put the volume on the maximum now. It's maxed, all was maxed, so I'm going to put the music back on right where I left it. I will need to try to check it on again on YouTube, so because I stopped the song, sadly. Going to try to put this, it's buffering, but you already can see how it works.